Hello, wealthy family, and welcome to today's Mindset Monday. Thank you so much for coming and sharing some time with me. I love and appreciate you all. Thank you, everyone, for the birthday wishes. You know, yesterday, Sunday, was my solar return. Today is actually my husband's solar return, and he is traveling. I love you so much, baby. Thank you so much for all your support. Thank you for this weekend. It was amazing. Yes, we celebrated our life like it was the end of the world. Like, we had so much fun. But I am thankful for everyone for the wishes and the donations and the gifts. Like, that was great. So thank you all. You're such a wonderful part of my life, and I appreciate each and every one of you. So today's Mindset Monday is going to be a piggyback off of our soul journaling prompt. Today is actually day 43 out of 60. And when I tell you, I'm so surprised of the time and how fast it's gone, and you know, the pride that I have not only in myself but for everyone who's been rocking with me, I'm thankful. I know I keep saying that, but I'm thankful for you all, because you all helped me to grow, right? And today's soul journaling prompt was about how you talk to yourself, right? And what you would change, not if you could, because you definitely can, but what you would change immediately to see a benefit for you. So let's take this soul journaling prompt mission, for example. When I first had this inspired thought in December, it took a while for me to say it out loud and to commit to it, because I immediately was like, this is such a good thing. I'm going to help everyone. I'm going to help me. But then here comes the voice of, you don't have a big enough following. Who's really going to follow? Who's really following you? Who's really going to find benefit in it? Just because it helped you doesn't mean it helped others. You can't do this. You've never done it before. Are you really going to sit here and commit to doing something every single day, getting a video up before 9:30 in the morning, right? Are you really going to do that? Like, all these things started coming, and I was like, no, that's not what we're doing. We got this, right? Every thought that comes through is an inspired thought. And Chanel, you got it. You can do this, right? I do so much already. I can commit to this one thing to not only prove to myself that I can move forward and get this done, but also to help my following, right? To help my family, to help our community grow. So that self-talk that I had initially that was not conducive, that wasn't helping me to grow, I find that many of us have that in our everyday lives. And a lot of the times, it's not on us, right? It's not because something is something that we naturally would do. But again, it's something that's been ingrained from when we were younger. So for me, I used to find myself echoing a lot of my mother's sentiments. My mother, a beautiful woman, strong woman, right? Determined and just lovely all around, okay? However, some of her ideals have kept her from achieving certain things. And I would find myself mirroring those same ideals. And when I go off to do something that I feel she wouldn't approve of, I would be hearing those voices, thinking that is myself, thinking that is my voice that's keeping me protected, keeping me safe. Right? But really, it was just my mother's sentiments, right? So I had to change that around, even the way on how I address myself. You know, when I was younger, I used to always think of myself as a queen or as a princess, right? Because I used to love Disney movies, so I would always address myself that way. And when I would do something and mess up, I would hear again my mother's scolding voice, right? Calling myself out my name instead of being gentle with myself. As I got older and got exposed to different things, my titles changed as well, right? I started calling myself the B word a lot, right? When I spoke to myself. And there's nothing wrong with that, but your title is everything, right? Your self-talk is everything. The title that you give yourself is everything, because that's the place that you hold your self-esteem, okay? So for a while, I was holding myself at the same level of people that weren't aspiring to do much better. And there's no knock to that because, again, everyone has a purpose, everyone has a place. But I didn't want to be stuck there. That's not where I wanted to be. I wanted to grow and elevate. So I had to change up that self-talk, right? And I had to realize that the things that were echoing were not just from myself or, you know, from my outside sources, or not just from my mother, but from things that were built up and pent up inside of me, how I felt I should be spoken to. So now, if I'm speaking to myself on such a low level energetic tone, how do you think other people are going to address me? So at that time of my life, when I moved from calling myself a queen and a princess to calling myself the B word, and I do still sometimes, because sometimes that's the energy you need, like, let me just get it together, right? But on a consistent basis, when I found myself calling myself that title, right, and scolding myself for little minute things, how dare you, how you mess this up, what a flipping idiot, get it together, like cussing myself, y'all, right? My first line of defense, the me, I was belittling myself so much, so I felt that's what I deserved. And that was at a time when I was in my abusive relationship, but I felt that I deserved that. That's where I was keeping myself at, right? So as I started to grow in my identity and say, you know what, you're not ugly, you're not stupid. I mean, I was in the top 5%, I think it's 5%. I was in my top five or 10, right, percent of my class, of my curricular, of my school, right? I was in a gifted program. I've always been recognized for my stellar vocabulary, but I'm diverse, so I can switch it up. And sometimes I would dumb those things down to fit in with the environment of where I was, because I grew up in the hood. I'm from Miami, right? So sometimes I would down that down and I would whittle it down because that's what I felt I deserved. Not knowing that there's a time and place for everything, and I didn't have to stay there. I didn't have to live there. I didn't have to keep belittling myself. And it was okay for me to make mistakes, and it's okay for me to mess up. But if I continuously beat myself down, now when someone else comes to do it, I'm gonna accept it, right? Because that's where I'm comfortable. That's what I feel I deserve. I'm gonna accept it. I'm open to it. So I'm open to the abuse. I'm open to the turmoil. I'm open to the criticism. Whereas that's not what I deserve. But because I wasn't allowing myself to see my true worth and my true power, I was just accepting it, right? I was just a receptacle for people to come and dump on, right? For them to feel better about themselves, but belittling myself in the process. So when I started taking note, right? Like someone would say, you're so beautiful. And I'd be like, yeah, whatever. They just trying to do da-da-da-da-da, right? Not able to take a compliment. When I started catching that, that's what made me start changing my self-talk. I'm like, what is wrong with you, girl? You are beautiful. Like, I've been shown that time and time again, right? I've been shown that I'm smart. I've been shown that I'm witty. I've been shown that I'm wise beyond my years. And I have to stop pushing that away based off some pre-programmed ideology that's been ingrained in me that I'm not worthy of that, right? So I started catching it, and I started saying, stop that. Accept the compliment. Yes, I am beautiful. Thank you. Yes, I am smart. Thank you. Yes, I am deserving. Thank you. It started off with those little things, learning how to accept the compliments, right? And then really looking at myself, that exercise that we did with the journaling prompt, looking at yourself in the mirror. I had to look at myself in the mirror and see and feel what I was being reflected back. I had to look beyond my face, look beyond my skin, look beyond what it is that everyone else saw, and look deep into my eyes, look deep into my soul, and allow the authentic thoughts to start pouring and bubbling forth. I could tell because the voice was different. I was feeling different. So I was able to shut down the idiot and the stupid and the ugly and you're not worthy and how dare you and so wouldn't approve of it. I was able to shut that down once I started really looking at me. And then I was able to give myself a title, give myself a name, and start living and embodying that and knowing that that's my predominant energy, right? And when I have that as my predominant set point, Now, when I go out to deal with the world, they're going to address me just the same. Because I'm not accepting. I'm not open to anything less than. You will not treat me like anyone else on the street because I embody my goddess energy. That is who I am. And when I talk to myself, yes, goddess, you got it. Yes, goddess, you can do this. Yes, goddess, it may be difficult, but you can work through it because that's what a goddess is. Having the ability, and a god, having the ability to see situations from a peripheral and allow it to be tailored to fit yourself and others. I don't look at things just singular for me. I look at how it can benefit myself and others. Myself first and others. And you can call it selfish if you want to. But if I don't look out for me first, who is going to look out for? Who's going to look out for me? You have to embody that energy and see how it is that you feel about yourself, how you talk to yourself. Because the way how you talk to yourself is how you're going to allow other people to talk to you and treat you. People are only going to do what you allow them to do. So once you realize that you are worth more than some foolishness and the down talk, and you realize that you're probably echoing things from your younger days, and it's not even really authentically you, when you start moving in that, you start to soar. Nothing can hold you back. Nothing can stop you because you know who you are. So, wealthy family, that's all that I have for you today. Thank you for sharing some time with me during this Mindset Monday. And as always, continue to stay alert, stay aware, and live in love. Peace.